How you doing, guys? It's Alessandro here from Spicy Moustache with some new tips in order to help you creating your own green area, indoor or outdoor, following the principle of do as nature does. Gardening in a small space could be much more productive per square meter than a large-scale garden. The reason is that you need to be more creative and fit as many plants as you can to use the full potential of your growing space. Also, it's a great way to master how to grow certain plants from seed to harvest, and it will make it much easier one day to scale up to a bigger space. So dig up that like button, and today I'll share with you 10 of my best tips to start growing your own food in a small space. First thing that I would like to recommend is to recycle as many materials as you can. You can make loads of DIY projects and you reduce your wastage by reusing all materials. If you live in a city like myself, it's a good idea to just have a walk around and collect materials that people don't use, or ask your neighbors to give you some old materials. I managed to create many different projects using secondhand materials in my garden, like a fire pit thanks to some old bricks that were left over from one of my neighbors, but also a bench by repurposing some old flooring boards that I found on another neighbor's house. And I also made some planters out of some old tires, and I managed to create two vertical gardens by simply using plastic bottles. Just a quick tip: if you're using old tires, remember to line the inside of the tires with another material so you won't have chemical leakage inside your soil. Making your own compost will have a great impact on your finances and benefits for your garden. By using a simple barrel like mine, you could potentially make enough compost to cover all your pots and raised beds for the whole season. Also, it's a great sustainable way to reduce the amount of food scraps that you chuck away daily. My compost bin is sitting on a concrete floor, and contrary to the common beliefs, it doesn't smell at all. This means that you could have this on your patio, small garden or balcony. You just need to have the right ratio of carbon, so dry things, and nitrogen, green things, and your compost will smell great. I made a video all about how to transform a barrel like this one into a compost bin in a few easy steps. I mentioned many times how you need to reinvent yourself to maximize your food production, not only horizontally, but also vertically. I use different kinds of vertical gardens thanks to my fence, my greenhouse, or DIY projects that I built in the past. Literally any vertical space could be used to grow food, including walls and even stairs. Doing so, you will extend your growing space, if not doubling the amount of food that you could potentially harvest. I will add a few links to videos that I made in the past to build your DIY vertical garden, but there are also many more if you keep scrolling through my profile. Another tip that I highly recommend is to grow your own herbs. They're one of the most expensive things from the supermarket, but are also one of the easiest things to grow. I dedicated this raised bed growing rosemary, oregano, two varieties of chives and thyme. They do great in pots, and most herbs survive throughout the winter and come back in spring. This will have a huge impact on your garden and your kitchen, because the amount of flavor that you can get from a smaller area like this one, it's brilliant. A great technique to have a constant production of food without having to wait for the plant to finish producing it is to use succession planting. For example, with beans, you would wait until they grow to roughly 1 meter tall, and then you could plant courgettes or squash at the base. Once you harvest your beans, cut the plant at the base for two main reasons. First of all, you don't want to disturb the roots of squash or courgettes growing in succession. And also, there are nitrogen fixes, so they're basically storing nitrogen at the roots level into nodules that will slowly release it into the soil available for your squash or courgettes. By the time your beans are ready, the squash will already start producing some fruit. This is just an example, but there are many other plants that you could plant following the succession planting techniques. Invest in heirloom seeds, hybrid seeds, open pollinated seeds that are less prone to disease and are known to produce lush plants. Your local grocery store or garden center should carry this kind of seeds. Alternatively, you can look online for really good seeds and non-GMO. Saving seeds is an important step to save your produce over the years. After about 5 years, their germination rate goes down to 60-75%. After 10 years, it goes down to 25-50%, but still viable. But after 20 years, it's recommended to just chuck them away, as it's not worth to try and germinate them. You can do a float test to check if your seeds are good to be germinated. To do that, you need a glass of room temperature water and some seeds. Put the seeds that you want to test into the water, and it is said that sinkers have potential to germinate, floaters do not. Mulching is a great technique to maintain moisture for a longer time, so you won't have to water your garden too many times throughout the week. When plants are planted in open ground, they have access to water sources deep down into your soil. However, as we're planting into pots or raised beds, they have limited access to water sources. Mulching is also great to protect your soil web, slow release of minerals, and also depending on what you're using, it could repel slugs and snails. Sourcing mulch in a city could be pretty challenging, so I would recommend to contact your local council once they come to prune the trees along your street, or to go to your local park and ask them to give you some of the wood chips once they prune down the trees. Alternatively, if your base is close to a beach, you could source some seaweed and use it in your garden, as it's packed with nutrients and beneficial microorganisms for your garden. The easiest way to turn a backyard lawn into an organic food producing garden is by using a lasagna garden, which doesn't require any digging. A lasagna gardening is a technique that is often referred to as sheet composting or sheet mulch layering. It's a great way to keep kitchen food waste standing up in landfill, and it's also a great way to easily start producing food at home. It's one of those fabulous ways to convert a high maintenance lawn into an eco-friendly place and possibly an organic garden. Lasagna gardening produces a light textured soil ready to plant up and start producing your own food in shade or full sun. It's both a simple and super satisfying way of transforming an area and start straight away to produce your own food. Lasagna gardening simply refers to the fact that you're layering soil, mulch, and root barriers, using the existing nutrients of your lawn and stopping your weeds to grow through. However, when your weeds start growing through, what you need to do is to simply remove them by hand without any digging. When a plant finishes to produce, just simply cut it at the base and leave the roots in the ground, because they will slowly turn into new nutrients for the plants that you're gonna plant after in the same area. A great advantage to grow in small spaces is that you can use plants that do well in shade. If you trellis cucumbers vertically, like I've got here, you could potentially plant lettuce in pot and move it throughout the summer following the shade created by your trellis. This is great because most gardeners struggle to grow lettuce in full summer because it tends to bolt and go into flower. But thanks to your small space, you can grow things that people with a huge field struggle to grow. You can also grow many other things in a shady area, like parsley, mint, or oregano. And I also use radishes all around the base of my cucumbers, so they are shaded by the huge leaves and the tall trellis. You could try growing fast and slow growing crops together, also called intercropping, to maximize space and harvest. Most crops that take up lots of space, like for example tomatoes and potatoes, they don't fill up the space until they reach full maturity. Take advantages of this by growing a few fast-growing radishes, salad leaves, or beetroots in between the rows of your main crops. By the time the space is needed by your large growing crops, your fast-growing crops will be long gone. It's possible to grow food anywhere in the world, and you should start now. I'm saying this not only because it's much healthier for your body, but it will also help to reduce your wastage, your carbon footprint, and support these big producers that care only about the revenue. We need to rediscover the missing link with nature and start being aware of our surrounding and our connection with the world. I hope these tips helps you to start growing your own food. And if you have any questions, please leave it in the comments and I will be happy to help you out. I hope you liked this video, and if so, please subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification settings so you can be notified every time I post a new video. And I'll see you next Friday for a new episode. Thank you so much for watching. See ya.